Hello students, welcome to Standard 8 Science online class. Students, in our today online class, we are going to learn our new unit 3, light. So in this lesson, we are going to acquire the knowledge about various types of mirror and then application of spherical mirrors, laws of reflection, and then compare about regular and irregular reflection, working principle of kaleidoscope and periscope. Lofty mountains covered with greenish vegetation, magnificent trees reaching the clouds, beautiful streams drifting down the valleys, bluish sea water roaring towards the coast, and the radiant sky in the morning being filled with the golden and red color. So all give delight to our eyes and peace to our mind. But we can see them all without light is a question. Students, it is impossible. So we can see all the things with the help of light. So, no, because we can see things around us only with the help of light. So, which is light reflected by them reaches our eyes. So, here is the question. What is light? So, light is a form of energy which travel in a straight line. So, in the form of wave. You have studied in your lower classes how it is reflected by the polished surfaces such as plane mirror, and then this reflecting property of light is applied in various devices that we use in our daily life. In this lesson, you will study about the types of mirrors like spherical mirror, parabolic mirror, see here the curved mirror are said to be as parabolic mirror, and also you will study about laws of reflection and laws of refraction and some of optical instruments like kaleidoscope and periscope. Students, we use mirrors in our daily life for various purposes. Mainly, we use them for beautifying. Students, the mirror is an optical device with a polished surface because the rough surface will not give perfect reflection. So, that reflect the light falling on it. So, a typical mirror is a glass sheet coated with aluminium or silver. Then only it will produce image on one side. So, the mirror have a plane or curved surface. So, the mirror have a plane or curved surface. Curved surface that are spherical, cylindrical, parabolic. So, example for curved surfaces are spherical mirror, cylindrical mirror, and then parabolic mirror, and also ellipsoid mirror. The shape of mirror determines, the type of images, form on it. For example, the plane mirror form perfect image of an object. So, we using the beautifying mirror is example for plane mirror. So, which is form a perfect image of an object. Whereas, curved mirror produce images that are either enlarged meaning big size or huge size, or diminished small size. So curved mirror produce images that are either enlarged or diminished, but the plane mirror produced perfect image or same size image. Do you know part important book inside question? The method of coating glass plates with a thin layer of reflecting metals was in practice during 16th century in Venice, Italy. So they used amalgam. So they use amalgam of tin and mercury for this purpose. For coating purpose, they use amalgam of tin and mercury. Nowadays, a thin layer of molten aluminium. So molten meaning which is in liquid state. Molten aluminium or silver is used for coating glass plate that will be then become mirrors. Classification of mirrors. Mirrors are classified into two groups. They are plane mirrors and curved mirrors. And then curved mirrors are classified into four types. They are spherical mirror, cylindrical mirror, parabolic mirror and ellipsoid mirror. Let me first explain you about spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors are one form of curved mirrors because curved mirror is classified into four types. What are they? Spherical mirror, cylindrical mirror, parabolic mirror, ellipsoid mirror. So spherical mirror are one form of curved mirrors. It is not plane mirror. So if the curved mirror is a part of sphere, then it is called a spherical mirror. So it is resemble the shape of piece cut. So piece cut out from a spherical surface. So you can see in this picture, the spherical mirror is resemble the shape of a piece cut. So piece cut out from a spherical surface. One side of this mirror is silvered and reflection of light occurs at the other side. So any one of the side is silvered and the other side, the reflection of light will occur. Our first mirror is a concave mirror. So this is the example. So this type of mirror is example for concave mirror. A spherical mirror in which the reflection of light occurs at its concave surface. So this surface, here the light will reflect. So the reflection of light take at the concave surface. It is called concave mirror. This mirror magnifies the object placed close to them. So the most common example of concave mirror is the makeup mirror. So makeup mirror is the most example for concave mirror. And then this is the example for convex mirror. So a spherical mirror in which the reflection of light occurs at its convex surface. So in this surface, the light will occur or reflect in this convex surface is called as convex mirror. So the image formed by this mirror is smaller than the object. So the image formed by convex mirror is smaller than the object. The most common convex mirror are rear viewing mirror, which is used in vehicle. So important question from book inside, do you know part? The convex mirror is used in vehicle as rear view mirrors and labeled with the safety warning. So the objects in the mirror are closer than they appear. So this is because inside the mirrors, vehicle will appear to be coming at a long distance. Our next topic is parabolic mirrors. Students, parabolic mirrors are the another form of curved mirror. It has a concave reflecting surface. So parabolic mirror has a concave reflecting surface, and the surface directs the entire incident beam of light to converge at its focal point or at a certain point. In the same way, light rays generated, produced by source placed at the focal point, will fall on this surface. Which surface? Parabolic surface. They will be diverged. Diverged meaning split the light rays. So diverged in a direction which is parallel to the principal axis of the parabolic mirror. Hence the light rays will be reflected to travel a long distance without getting diminished. Diminished meaning reduced. So the parabolic mirror, also known as parabolic reflectors, they used to collect or project light energy, heat energy, sound energy and radio waves. So important 2-mark question. The parabolic mirror, also known as parabolic reflector, the uses of parabolic mirrors are to collect or project light energy, heat energy, sound energy and radio waves, and also used in reflecting telescopes, radio telescope and parabolic microphone. They also used in solar cooker and a solar water heater.